How do you attract a girl who was into you, but you killed the attraction through low value behavior, specifically one you see regularly? Thanks for the content you put out. All right, so first of all, I'm gonna refer you. I've done videos on the friend zone before. This video is gonna be very similar to a friend zone type concept, and it almost sounds like this is coming from a friend zone area. But in this case, I will talk about if it's been specific low value behaviors as opposed to just a lack of premise. So it is a slightly different question, but it's a very similar answer. And the answer is this, of good news and bad news. Good news is, if you are seeing this girl over and over, if you're seeing her on a regular basis, there is an opportunity. As long as you have contact with someone, as long as you have the ability to get into an interaction with them, you can do good things. Because today is the first day of the rest of your life, to choose a cheesy phrase from the 70s, right? Today is the first day of the rest of your life. You can, from this moment, start being a high value guy. And over time, the perception that person has of you will start to be weighted towards you being that high value guy. See, people's perceptions of you are basically a cross section. They're basically the sample that you've given them of your personality, right? You've given them a sample of your personality, and that's what they believe is you. Every new bit of information you give them adjusts that sample. So if you've been low value and start acting high value, now they still think of you as low value, but they're starting to think, oh, well, maybe he's a little bit high value in this context or this context. And over time, if you've done a lot more high value than low value, then you're going to start to be perceived more and more and more high value in their eyes. But that previous low value still does kind of hang on the weighting and act against you. The nice thing, though, is that the weighting is skewed towards recent. So let's say maybe you've known someone your whole life, they're gonna give a lot more credence to how you act now and how you've acted in the last year than how you acted when you were 4 years old, because that's who you are now, all right? So the nice thing is, even though maybe you have a long history of maybe some low value negative behaviors, and now you're taking on positive behaviors, it may seem like it would take a really long time to outweigh those negative behaviors, and you're right, it will take some time. But the nice thing is that the more recent behaviors are going to be considered more real and more valid, so they will outweigh more quickly, right? It's kind of like a weighted average, like weighted to the present. So that's the good news is that you can do it. The bad news is that it is hard. There is that weight against you. The other bad news is you're going to have to actually step up and change, right? Doing more of the same stuff won't help you get a different result. It'll help you get the same result. And it's the same advice I give to people in the friend zone, which is, if I were put in your shoes, I would get out of the friend zone really quickly, because I'm not going to be the person that got myself there in the first place. For you, if you're used to adopting certain low vibe behaviors, you have a certain nature to a relationship with someone, it's hard to break that mold, and there will be resistance to it, both on your part and on hers. So on your part, there'll be resistance because you don't want to ruin the friendship, or you don't want to take a risk, or it will feel socially awkward or whatever. There'll be resistance on her part because it feels incongruent. People don't like incongruence with people. People like to be able to know who someone is and trust that and whatever. So if they think of you one way and you start acting out of character, they're going to think you're being fake. And, you know, to an extent, maybe you actually are being fake, because you may be faking it till you make it in classic game style. But there is going to be some resistance to that incongruence. In fact, you're probably better off, instead of being, if you're very low value, if you go very, very low value to very high value, it might actually be super jarring, and it might actually be like someone just won't trust you, or someone will just be like, think you just become an asshole or something like that. So what you might want to do is start adding in little bits. The nice thing, again, here's your advantage. Your advantage is you are going to keep seeing them. So you do have time. That's the one thing on your side here is time. So if you were, we'll say value on a 1 to 10 scale, just like arbitrarily, if you were at like a 3 out of 10 value level throughout the course of the relationship, and you throw in some occasional little bits of value, enough to bring you up to like a 5 or 6 out of 10 overall, then you'll start to ramp up in your perceived value. And then once you're perceived at a 5 or 6 out of 10, you can drop in a little more value to the point where you're 7 and 8, a little more to where you're 9 and 10. Whereas if you went from 3 to 10, people would just think you're acting weird, or you might get a lot of shit for it. You might get a lot of like, what the fuck are you doing? Why are you being this way? It makes people uncomfortable when people change suddenly. So what you should start doing is kind of baby stepping in the direction you'd like to go. The other nice thing about baby stepping is that it will avoid a lot of potential rejections and a lot of potential negatives that could come from massively escalating or massively changing things, right? So if you go 5% towards being super high value and that's perceived well, and responded to well, then you go 5 more percent and 5 more percent, and you will get there quickly. Here's the beautiful thing about social interactions and game in general. As long as you're moving in the right direction, you will get there quickly. The things that slow you down are not that you're not moving quickly enough, it's that you're getting rejections or that you're backtracking, right? So as long as you're upping the value and upping the value and upping the value, it doesn't matter too much if the upping the value is in really, really small doses, as long as it's continuous. What will not help is if you try and be high value, you get a negative reaction and then you act really apologetic and low value, then you're just gonna be perceived as that same low value guy, if not even lower value, and incongruent and untrustworthy. And the next time you try and be high value, it will be received even worse, okay? So that I don't recommend. What I recommend, ratchet it up a little bit, just adopt some of the high value behaviors, see what the response is, adopt some more, see what the response is, adopt some of them more, see what the response is. Be a little bit patient if you are gonna see someone over and over again, but definitely start right away with conveying yourself and being the person you want to be. Because it's gonna take some time, but again, as long as communication is open, as long as you have the opportunity to see someone, you're going to have an opportunity to convey yourself in the right way and win them over through the weight of evidence. As soon as communication is off, as soon as you no longer have a way to see that person or interact with that person, that's when it's typically kind of all over and it'll get really difficult. And that gets especially difficult because once you're in a low value place and you can't see the person, the ways to be able to see the person are needy or more low value and may just be kind of like a downward spiral from there. So as long as you still have that interaction, as long as you're still seeing someone, there is a chance, but you have to handle it the right way. And mostly you have to stop being the person that put yourself in that low value frame in the first place, but do it with some intelligence. All right, so hopefully you liked that answer. If you did, like, subscribe to the channel, post your questions below, and I will see you on the next video. Take care.